Start by opening a blank canvas. You can use any canvas you want. And then press T for text and change your font, make it League Spartan. And type a big letter H. Make it capital letter, not home. In this instance, we're going to be using a lime green for our design. And we're going to move the H to the side, press another T for text, continue using League Spartan, and type studio on the name. And use a brighter green on this one, and spread by spacing your letters so that they still align to your H, but they're nicely spread in a written format. Next, you're going to go to your elements and you're gonna search for curve. We're looking for this curved shape that's called banner shape curve silhouette. You add it to the design and then rotate it so that it's pointing up. Reduce the size while rotating and then change the color, make it that greenish, this nice bright green, and then duplicate the shape and then flip it vertically and bring it to the bottom of the page and start aligning your curves so that they don't have those extra gaps on there. Rotate the curve so it's pointing down. Once it's aligned like this, you're going to group these two shapes. We want to align them to our H, so I just want to see how our design looks like. Now we're ready for the next step. We're going to bring our H to the middle of the page and our studio and our curve. And we're going to change it to a color to gray and red. It's just going to look much better on Photopea. That extra little space that you see there, I don't like. It's going to look very crappy on our design. So we need to fix that. What we're going to do is we're going to select the curves. We're going to ungroup them. And we're going to pick the first curve. We're going to duplicate that. And we're just going to gently align it over there so that it covers that little extra that you see there that does not look professional at all. Once we are happy, we are going to then access Typecraft in order to write the rest of the name for our design. So what you're going to do is you select Typecraft. You can search for it if you don't have it under your apps and it will open up. Then you're going to type creative or whichever word you want to use. And you're going to use the font Legend Bold. And we leave it with no style, as clear as that. And we change the color and we make it a nice bright red. And we scroll down. And the word is on the edit shape. What you then now do, you add this to your design. And it looks like that. And you will rotate it so that it is in the direction where you want to design. So you will slant it. I don't know what's the English word for it. And then you will also size it and make it almost the size that you want. That's very important that you start with that instead of editing the shape on the left hand side first. Once you've slanted it and it looks like this, we can then now start designing. So we are going to go to the edit shape and start using the points to twist this design of ours. Now we want to add the C to be aligned with the H at the bottom of the page. So also make this a little bit bigger. And start using the points to adjust the design.
and the update element, and it starts twisting the way that we want it to twist.
So be very gentle with yourself and the tool. Update every time you make a change and be very gentle with yourself. Click and update, click and update, twist it until you're comfortable and you're happy that it is in the right area that you want. And there's your design, nicely done, finished. You're going to download this and you're going to scroll and add a second page and grab the design you've just downloaded back to Canva, and we click on edit image. We use the old remove background and we take off the white and the extra shapes that we've added and converted to white, and our design is nicely done. We click on apply, we go to share, and we download as a transparent background, and we want page number 2 stuff. Then we access Photopea and we select template. Now we're going to convert it to 3D. I love this first one. You can use any mockup you want. You open the mockups, you click on the link to open the design. Opens it up. You're going to double click where it says your logo here, and you're going to hide the example. And we drag the transparent design that we did on Canva now. We align it. We make it nice and big as the example we've just seen. Then we press Command S or Control S on Windows to convert it to Smart Object. And then we click on the first tab to access our design. I think it looks stunning. I really do. You're going to export it as a JPEG or a PNG based on whatever need you have. If you enjoy these tutorials, please go to our playlist for our logos and get inspired. Thank you for joining me on our creative studio. I will see you on the next video.